The Mi Mix 4 may very well be one of the best smartphones of the year so far, thanks to being the world's first phone powered by the Snapdragon 888 Plus chipset and being Xiaomi's very first mass-produced smartphone to house an under-display selfie camera. But one of my favorite things about the Mi Mix 4 is the return of 120-watt fast wire charging, which was last seen in the Mi 10 Ultra last year. The Xiaomi Mi Mix 4 is packed with a 4,500 mAh battery split into 2,250 mAh cells and utilizes MTW multi-pole technology, which apparently increases charging speed and reduces charging temperature. The Mi Mix 4 has been packed with a new feature known as boost mode, which can apparently charge your phone faster between 0 and 80%. I wonder what's going to happen in the last 20% if it does revert to default. How slow will that be? Though it shouldn't revert to default, since I have made sure to disable optimized charging, which usually caps your battery at 80% and trickles through the last 20%. I will also be using an infrared thermometer gun, which I will test out on the phone every 10%. Of course, the Mi Mix 4 does come with the massive 120-watt charging brick in the box. It is 20 volts by 6 amps, which equals 120 watts. I've also managed to get my hands on a power consumption watt energy meter, which will be at the bottom left of the screen throughout the video, just to see if we are truly hitting 120 watts all the time. Xiaomi already has a concept phone that sports 200 watt wired charging, but until that technology is available to the public, 120 watts will have to do. With that said, can the Mi Mix 4 charge faster than the Mi 10 Ultra? And if so, by how much? This is Tech Nick, and without further ado, let's find out. Before we get things going, it is worth mentioning that we do have the percentage of the Mix 4 at the top of the screen. We will be doing different brackets throughout the test, 1 to 10%, 10 to 20%, so on and so forth. Within these brackets, I will be measuring the minutes, not from 1 to 60%, for example, but it will be from 50 to 60%. So maybe 1 to 10% is 1 minute. When I go from 10 to 20%, it might be another minute, but I won't add them together. At the end of the test, I will give a total minute score from 0 to 100, which you can honestly just check throughout the test at the top left corner when you take a look at the timer over there and the percentage right at the top of the screen, like I mentioned before. Of course, we will also be using the included 120 watt charging brick and 6 ampere cable that came bundled in the box, and popping the Mix 4 on charge for the first time, tapping the starter timer at the top left hand corner. That charging animation looks fantastic. It says 120 watt max, so it can do anything below that. We're sitting at around 100 watts for now. After just 1 minute, we got 10%. After 2 minutes, we got 20%, and we are getting to the 30% in just over 3 minutes, which is fantastic, reaching that 40% mark in just 4.5 minutes and getting to 50%. This phone is ridiculously quick at just under 6 minutes. Moving on to the 60% mark, we're hitting in just 7 minutes, and moving through to that 70% mark, something strange happened. This is the longest period which it took to charge. I did have boost charging enabled and charge optimization disabled, but it was doing something strange and only charging at 10 watts. I decided to unplug it for a millisecond and plug it back in. It didn't really improve it, so I decided to go ahead and disable boost charging, enable it again, and still it wasn't really improving. I guess it is kind of that point in time where it tries to cool down, which makes sense since after 60% it reached almost 54 degrees in Celsius, so it needed to start cooling things down. Now it is starting to speed up again, reaching that 100% mark in no time. Unfortunately, it didn't do it in its advertised time of 15 minutes, but it has done it in 21 minutes, which is still absolutely phenomenal to reach 1 to 100% on the Xiaomi Mi Mix 4. Now, before we start speaking about how it compares to other devices around, it is worth checking out this table that I kind of brushed through throughout the test. 1 to 10% and 10 to 20% were the quickest, just doing 1 minute each in those interval brackets. And the 10 to 20% mark had the highest milliampere per minute reading of 450 milliampere per minute. Now, you've also got to bear in mind that that milliampere per minute reading is for between the bracket of 10 and 20% and not necessarily between 1 and 20%. 20 to 30% all the way up to 50 to 60% wasn't bad, but reaching that 50 to 60% point, we kind of reached our peak and the phone started getting hot, reaching 53.9 degrees in Celsius, which means that between 60 and 70%, we had the longest 10% jump of 5 minutes and 9 seconds. But you can notice that after the 70% mark, it did slightly drop in temperature down to 50.4 degrees in Celsius. And it dropped again once reaching 80%. And in that 10 minute bracket, it started increasing its milliampere per minute reading, and going to the 90% mark, it started getting hotter again. But that is because it started started increasing its wattage speed and getting 203.01 milliamp hours per minute. Then it started to try cool itself down again between 90 and 100%, which slowed down the milliamp hour per minute reading of 121.08 and decreased the temperature just by a 0.1. The Mi Mix 4 did its first 50% in 6 minutes, which is insane. It got a milliamp hour per minute reading within that first 50% of almost 400 milliamp hours per minute. It matched the 6 minute 0 to 50% of the Vivo iQOO 7, and that got a 333.3 milliamp hour per minute reading within its first 50%. We've also got to bear in mind that the iQOO 7 has a significantly smaller battery than the Mix 4 at 4,000 milliamps, as opposed to the 4,500 milliamp hour cell on the Mi Mix 4. Now, the Mi Mix 4, Black Shark 4 Pro, and Xiaomi Mi 10 Ultra all have the same battery capacity at 4,500 milliamps and 120 watt charging, but the Black Shark 4 Pro did the first 50% in just 7 minutes with 321.4 milliamp hours per minute reading within that first 50%, and the Mi 10 Ultra with the same size battery and same wattage charging did the first 50% in 10 minutes. When it comes to overall score, the iQOO 7 was still up at the top, doing 0 to 100% in just 16 minutes. Then we had the Black Shark 4 Pro doing it in 17 minutes, the Mi Mix 4 doing it in 21 minutes, but the Mi Mix 4 was still a hell of a lot quicker than the 28 minute Mi 10 Ultra. Also, do bear in mind that these are my own test results, which I have personally done on my channel, and these are not the advertised times of these phones or other channel charging test results. And in terms of temperature, the hottest peak temp throughout the test of all four of these devices was indeed the Mi Mix 4 with 53.9 degrees in Celsius, which makes you wonder if the MTW multipole technology, which is used in order to increase charging speed and reduce temperature, really works in favor of the temperature side of things. Even though recording this charging speed test didn't really take that long, just 21 minutes thanks to the ridiculously fast charging Mi Mix 4, the post-processing and editing this video, putting it all together, took a hell of a long time. So if you have yet to do so, please make sure you smash that subscribe button down below. Stay tuned for my full review of the Mi Mix 4, which should pop around in the next few days. This is Tech Nick, and I'll catch you in the next one.